course, we have no history ever with any wild bobcat we get, and this one was very sick when we originally got it. We didn't know what was wrong with it. Luckily, it recovered, but unlike many bobcats, especially Florida bobcats that we see, it's got rather short legs. It's a little bit wider than it should be, and its head is a little bit, the shape of its head is a little different. So it's got a little bit more on top and a little bit more on the sides, and so we always worry about congenital defects of any kind, whether it be something that could show up in the blood work or it could be neurological, something like hydrocephalus, which is like motor on the brain. So we haven't seen any real clinical signs of any of those things except for just physical appearance. So we're just kind of covering the bases. We'll make sure blood work's normal before we sedate, and then maybe take some x-rays and make sure there's nothing obvious. But if we see any neurologic signs, that might be an